Hello and welcome back to the Sharks World, ladies and gentlemen. Today's video is going to be covering an interesting article that confirms something I've always said. Plenty of you have seen clips of different species of animals fighting over food. Sometimes they're the same species. Most of the time, they're different species. But this article documents a scenario involving oceanic white tips and tiger sharks scavenging on a very small carcass, and they never fought. In fact, this entire encounter was peaceful and very well behaved. I've said it before, and I'll say it again. Sharks are decent people. But I'm getting ahead of myself. As always in my videos, I will leave a link to the article in the description below. Please, do yourself a favor and give it a good read. This event took place on April 9th, 2024, off the coast of Kailua Kona, Hawaii. A tour came across a very degraded carcass and notified the authors of this article for them to come and observe it. For reference, here's a picture of the carcass next to a tiger shark. They drifted with the carcass for over 8.5 hours and observed two species of sharks. 9 oceanic white tips and 5 tiger sharks were observed throughout the entire feeding. To be clear, they all didn't show up at once. Those are simply the total numbers that came and left during the observation time frame. Now, why is this event significant? For 2 reasons. Actually, 3. 1, it's sharks, and they're the best. 2, tiger sharks and oceanic white tips almost never encounter one another. At least not enough for it to be known as a common event. Oceanic white tips are rare enough, with them being an oceanic pelagic species. Seeing 9 of them over the span of 8 hours, yet alone with another species of apex predator, is kind of a big deal. Number 3, and the reason why I'm making this video, is that there was no aggressive behavior from either species. At all. In fact, the scientists noted that the interactions between the two species were rather peaceful. However, there was a pecking order dictated by size, as is usually the case with a lot of animals. For example, if 2 sharks were headed to the carcass at the same time, the smaller shark would give way to the larger one. Or, if a smaller shark was feeding and a larger shark approached the carcass, the smaller shark would leave. What's even crazier is that there were multiple times when a tiger shark and an oceanic white tip were feeding on the carcass at the same time. You can see in the series of photos, both species feeding side by side, peacefully. However, context is key. Tiger sharks were the bigger species in this event, outside of one smaller female. The 2 biggest of the oceanic white tips were the main ones feeding on the carcass at the surface with the tiger sharks. The smaller oceanic white tips and 1 smaller female tiger shark stayed roughly 5 meters below the surface and fed on the scraps that drifted down. These 2 different species of apex predator, who live completely different lives and rarely encounter each other, established and maintained 8.5 hours of order. Again, every interaction was peaceful and well-behaved. Which I'm sure leads to some of you asking, why didn't they fight over the carcass? And my response to that question is, stop thinking like a human. Think like a shark for a second. Here, let's back up and start from the top. When a young shark is born, it has to earn its meal every day and survive on its own from the get-go. Most sharks live solitary lives and don't know when they will get their next meal. They learn to take what they can get and are generalist predators. Because of this, nature designed sharks to conserve energy very well. It's part of the reason they're such efficient swimmers. It can go a long time without eating after a big meal. This also goes for their mannerisms. To answer the question from earlier, why would the sharks fight each other when there's enough carcass for everyone to get fed? And to be clear, this isn't necessarily altruistic, more along the lines of pragmatic. For example, remember during some of the first Airjaw specials, where there was that one gentleman that got on top of a whale carcass while white sharks were feeding on it. He was scared shitless because he didn't want to fall in. While that's not an irrational concern, he would have been fine if he did fall in. Because again, we gotta think like a shark. Why would they waste precious energy on something that can fight back or swim away when there's free mammal blubber for the taking? Similar thought process here with the tiger sharks and oceanic white tips. This is why sharks rarely fight each other, outside of predation, of course. And this event is a perfect demonstration of that. My following questions would be, are there other subtle communications that we missed during this encounter? If so, how was it done and why? How do sharks communicate with other shark species? How is it understood? Is there a deeper layer to shark communication that we're missing? Because I think there is. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. This is going to be where we end today's video. Thank you for once again giving me some of your time. Remember that sharks are the best animal in the world. Yes, better than elephants and tigers. And I'll see you in the next video. Until then.